My first quickie divorce was in Juarez. Reggie was such a fine, sweet, loving, filthy, rich oil man. When we met, I was 17, he 87. I was perfectly willing to have my itsy-bitsy, teeny-weeny little career there in Baton Rouge. But then we hired the drummer Pablo, and it was all over. Pablo was such a young, dark, eager Latin lover. Actually, he was Irish. Pablo or Reardon. But that didn't matter. Nothing mattered until I saw the lipstick stain on that white satin tie that I bought him in Rio de Janeiro. It was then that I became a veritable slave to his every whim. Days spent washing and ironing his shirts. Nights sitting at that cardboard table in that tawdry little trailer park in Tupelo, waiting for him to show. I tell myself what's done is done. I tell myself don't be a fool. Play the field, have a lot of fun. It's easy when you play it cool. I tell myself don't be a chump. Who cares? Let him stay away. That's when the phone rings and I jump. And as I grab the phone, I pray. Let it please be him. Or the other. It must be him. It must be him. Or I shall die. Or I shall die. Oh, hello. Hello. Oh, dear God. It must be him. But it's not him. That's when I die. Again, I die. For this vertebrae, I pick myself up off the floor. I told for this. Put my head self on the shelf again. He'll never hurt me anymore. I'll only hurt myself. I'm not a puppet on a string. I'll find somebody new someday. That's when the phone rings, right, Mary? Oh, hello, hello, oh dear God, it must be him.